You can't stand your partner and you're like mushing their face, like stop talking. All right, we're going back and doing weight because Chris said we missed it. We don't want to miss anything. Let's get into it. Okay, I wonder if this is the same girl. Well, not in the video, but like just from, I know the albums are different years and stuff, but I wonder if it's the same, he's writing about the same story.
Yeah.
If not, it seems like a similar issue. But it seems like a different side of it. So we were back and forth and all that.
Right.
And the other one, it seemed like she just like gave him the cold shoulder at some point or something.
Right.
You ready? Okay, I find this interesting because he's like, don't you miss us, you don't call back.
Mm-hmm.
He's on this song too. I mean, because we did the I Just Want to Know first, so we're kind of backwards, so we know about I Don't Want to Know. But okay, so on this song too, he seems to be on the like the end of the relationship where he's getting
the butt.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, he seems to be on that end of it again.
Yeah.
So it can't be the same relationship because the albums are far apart, but I guess he could just be writing about his relationship experiences overall.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like maybe he's always on that end of it.
Yeah. You know, I wasn't even listening to the words so much because I was just like admiring the versatility of him as an artist. Because I feel like this song is more of like a song than a rap.
It is, but it's not like purely a song. He's not purely singing. It's like in between singing and rapping.
Right? It's like he's saying something.
Right.
But artistically, which I think is very interesting.
It's like swaggy speaking.
Yeah, you know basically. What I mean? And the cinematics of this one is like human in the center and then like all kinds of like pans and zooms and like, you know what I mean? But it's like a lot of times you don't see, like you see like building in the distance and then like people doing stuff, you know what I mean?
Right.
So it's just like, yeah, dude's a complete artist. Like, you don't get that, I feel like, in most rappers.
Right.
Very interesting. Are you happy? Tell me, are you happy? Are you smiling? Are you smiling?
Just can't let go.
conversation. We don't want to think about it, we just want to fake it. We just want to act like everything is great. Go back to the day, put your movies in a base. And the problem is now, I feel like everything has changed. And I'm trying to make a living on the music, but I feel like every time I look at you, I'm in a place.
Okay, that when he started this verse, he's like, we don't want to have a conversation. We don't want to think about it, we just want to fake it or whatever. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's a big thing, and I feel like it leads to, like, passive aggressiveness.
Definitely. Definitely.
It's like when you're hanging around a couple or something, and they make those little, like, passive-aggressive remarks, and it's like, oh, got tense in here. Like, I don't want to say anything. Like, it makes everyone in the room feel awkward.
For sure. For sure. Because it's like, I mean, I don't know, talk about it. But I feel like a lot of times when people don't want to talk about it is because they don't want the, like, blow-up. You know, like, they don't want to, like, they just want to exchange how they feel and agree or disagree, but they don't want the, like, arguing and bickering and, like, you know what I mean?
Right, but then it's like, it is possible to talk about things without arguing.
Yeah, but most adults are not that mature. Most adults, literally, I feel like everyone throws tantrums all the time. It's like, I feel like most people in general just takes, like, they're already on edge, they're already at the tip of it, and it's just like, you say one thing, just slightly that they don't, boom, now it's just like,
right, yeah.
In a perfect world, it'd be nice, though.
Yeah. Just those passive-aggressive remarks, man. That's I don't like being around it.
It's very uncomfortable, because, like, not your place to say anything, but it's like, a lot of times, it's like, they're so, like, on the edge that it's the dumbest little tiny thing that pisses them off.
Right.
And then you're there, and, like...
It's like, I don't want to give any examples, just in case we have any family and friends that ever find our channel, because we haven't told anybody. No, maybe, like, 3 people.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we're just keeping it under wraps. Nobody knows. But, so I don't want to give any examples from that. Like, a trivial example I'm just going to make up on top of my head. Be like, serving dessert at family dinner or something, and, you know, husband's eating cake or the wife's eating cake, and the other one's like, oh, you're enjoying that cake, aren't you?
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, what's going on in this relationship? Right. Do you guys need some alone time? Like, you guys can do this when you go back home. You know what I mean? Right. It's like the passive-aggressive comments, like, oh, you guys need to talk more, you know?
Yeah.
We don't want to have a conversation. We don't want to think about it. We just want to fake it. We just want to act like everything is great. Go back to the day, watch your movies in the base. And the problem is now, I feel like everything has changed. And I'm trying to make a living on the music, but I feel like every time I look at you, I'm in a place. It's hard to be the man in a house when you ain't got a house.
I hate this.
It's complicated. It's complicated. It's complicated. We don't want to talk. We don't want to talk. It's complicated. I'm sitting in a hotel room like, why? I call your phone and apologize. Gotta be a way we can make this right. We can make this right. I'm holding on to pieces.
Okay, the end of that verse, he said there has to be a way we can make this right. But it sounds kind of like a toxic relationship. Like back and forth. I feel like the back and forth relationships can be kind of toxic. And then the no communication aspect. I mean, you could fix the no communication thing, I think, if both people open up. But it just sounds like it's not that healthy. And he said it's a desperate kind of love. You know what I mean?
That part of it, I agree with, for sure.
But that's how it is when you are in those desperate kind of love relationships.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, you break up, do whatever, we can make it work. One person wants to, one doesn't. Eventually, both make it work for a second.
I don't know. I feel like such a pessimist in this, but I'm just like, like, the word toxic relationship to me, I'm just like, what relationship isn't toxic? Like, there's literally, like, degrees of toxicity to where it's like, yes, every relationship, you're not going to agree on everything. You're going to have periods where you're, like, back and forth. Like, you're going to have periods where you can't freaking stand each other. But in general, there is a line of, like, you shouldn't be abusing each other. You know what I mean? You shouldn't, like, it should, you know, be able to be fixed and dealt with.
Right. And when you can't stand each other, how do you treat each other when you can't stand each other? I feel like that could be a difference maker. You know what I mean?
Yes, I know what you mean.
It's like, if you can't stand your partner and you're, like, mushing their face, like, stop talking.
Right,
like,
or calling them names.
Like, might be toxic.
Yeah. Do you get disrespectful, or is there, like, the respect is always there, even if you're on my last nerve right now? You
know? Right. I mean, I agree with what you're saying. Like, every level, every relationship has levels of toxicity.
Just, modern day, everybody wants to say, oh, toxic relationship. And it's like, no. Toxic, like, literally, there's immaturity. Like, people are immature and in relationships, so they don't know how to deal with their own selves, so then they put it off on their partner, you know?
Right.
But, like... toxic relationships, like, everybody knows that.
Right.
Everybody has those relatives where you know they got a toxic
relationship. The term is definitely overused. Like, people use it as kind of like a scapegoat. Oh, it was a toxic relationship. He was toxic. She was toxic. You know, oh, okay, well, you got out the toxic relationship. Great. And you find out that that person actually cheated who's calling the other person toxic. And everyone uses the term. It is what it is.
I feel like this one is interesting because it's like it's just his perspective. So like you said in the other video, it's like you want to see the girls. Because to me, it almost sounds like he needs to just move on because she doesn't want to put any effort. And like if nobody, if they're not giving back like 50%, then like it's toxic enough. You know what I mean? It's just she don't want it. So it's like, what can you do?
70-30 relationship. Yeah, it's not like, what you want.
Yeah, it's like, what can you do at that point? But I mean, how he's feeling in this moment, I feel like it might not be their problems are so, so bad.
Right.
You know, but
it's like, maybe she moved on because he's like, are you really happy and all that kind of stuff?
You never know with people. Oh my gosh, I just noticed something.
What?
So, he's in a hotel, and she's at the house. Mm-hmm. So, apparently, she kicked him out or something.
Oh.
Mm. So, that makes me think that he's calling, like, she's on the phone. I was like, who are they on the phone with? Because, like, seems like she's not picking up. Right. You know, but then she's on the phone, too, but he's at a hotel. She kicked him out.
Interesting. So it was a serious relationship. Mm-hmm. Okay.
But then he's packing his bag up at the hotel. So it's like, is he about to go back to her place? Their place?
Right. You be catching all the little things. I just miss them.
You catch other things. Just can't let go. I know this is a desperate kind of love, but it feels like it's home. So much. That last part, all the music's gone, just his voice. Don't leave me.
It did make it kind of like made it really emphasized the desperateness of it.
It was just so artistic. You know what I mean? The gravitas.
I just picture a person sitting there like, don't leave me, don't leave me. It's like, oh my goodness, this is a desperate kind of love.
It's like the gravitas at the end of his don't leave me, and then there's just like a little bit of silence, like pause. Oh, I love it. Wow, what an artist. Special character, special guy. Like, this is pretty cool.
He's been through a lot.
He has. But you know, I always think about this. Like, you have the artists that took lessons and studied and worked really, really hard, and you know, since they were a kid. And then you have the artists that just like they had a rough life, and they became an artist to like get it out. You know what I mean? And not that they didn't eventually practice, and you know,
they could have done both.
Right, they could have done both, but a lot of times, especially when they're young, it's just them. You know what I mean? Versus the other one that has, like, all these lessons and access to things. I'm like, a lot of times I feel like the people who struggle become artists, and the people with the lessons and all that become entertainers.
Right.
Which are both valuable. We love them all, but I feel like he's an artist.
For sure. 100%. But you really pick up on all the, like, cinematography stuff too. I don't pick up on all of it. I'm like, it's a good looking video.
I love
it. They got good cameras, good microphones.
I love it so much. It's just like, I feel like modern day you just get so much like fake stuff that it's like, just like so many music videos have like everything digitized, everything. You know what I mean? And it's like, they do cityscapes, yes, but it's like less about the story and more about how much can we like distract you and show you cool stuff, and you know what I mean?
Right.
And so I like appreciate dirty buildings and like basic sets, you know?
That's all I have on this.
Oh, how could you listen to the next?
It is. Unless someone has a different suggestion in the comments.
Yep. Any more suggestions before?
How could you leave us as the next one we're planning on doing?
Yeah.
But open to suggestions.
Anything we must do before that.
If you see a good suggestion in the comment, please like it so we can make sure we see it. Because I can't read all the comments. Try to read as many as we can.
Yeah.
We put out too many videos. Yeah. But we try to read as many as we can. But yeah. Let us know if there's anything else we should do before How Could You Leave Us.
Yeah.
But yeah, thanks for watching. Appreciate all the likes, all the comments, all the tips, all the pointers, all the interpretations and insights. Like, we learned down in the comments.
Yeah, you know we do. Like, we like learn so much.
Yeah, but we appreciate you guys. That's a wrap. I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know? What do you know? Me and my boys on the road. Where did it go? She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.